Hello everyone. We will conclude on the time instruction group with the counter instructions. First, set up the connection for today's demonstration with Arduino Nano, PC817 optocoupler module, a relay module, push button switches, indicator lamp, and power supply as shown in this connection diagram. The counters are of two types, the counter up, CTU, and the counter down, CTD. Drag a counter up into the room. The counter up status bit, CU, changes to true when the room condition is true. Each time CU changes to true, ACC value increases by 1. DN is true when the counter ACC value matches the preset value. OV only becomes true when ACC value exceeds plus 32,767. ROST instruction resets the counter. Assign C.1 variable to the counter. Set its preset value to 5. Drag a contact into the room with variable S.1. Drag a one-shot rising and place it between the contact and the counter. Insert a room and drag a contact and a coil into it. Assign the counter status of DN to the contact and arrow.1 to the coil. Insert another room and drag a contact and a reset instruction into it. Assign S.2 to the contact and the counter C.1 to the reset. Then go to simulation mode. Right-click on the S.1 button on the simulation window and observe that ACC value is increased by 1. Keep right-clicking on it until ACC is the same as the preset value. Observe that status DN is now true, which makes arrow.1 true. Right-click on S.2 button in the simulation window. Observe that ACC value is reset to 0, and DN is now false, which makes arrow.1 to be false. Upload the code to the PLC. Then, repeatedly press the push button switch connected to S.1 5 times. On the 5th press, the indicator lamp is turned on. Press the push button switch connected to S.2. The indicator lamp should go off. For the counter down, delete the counter up and drag a counter down into its place. The counter down CD status bit changes from false to true when the room condition is true. ACC value of the counter decreases from 0 each time the room condition changes from false to true. When ACC value goes below 0, DN changes from false to true. And when ACC is equal to the negative value of the preset, DN changes from true to false. UN becomes true when its value is less than minus 32,767. Now, set the preset value to minus 5 and select C.1 variable. Then, go to simulation mode and right-click on S.1 button in the simulation window. Observe that when the room condition is momentarily true, ACC value changes to minus 1. DN becomes true, as well as arrow.1. When ACC is less than minus 5, DN becomes false. The same counter variable can be assigned to a counter up and a counter down. This allows for the increasing and decreasing of a common ACC value. Delete the counter down in room 0 and insert a counter up in its place with variable C.1. Set its preset value to 5. Drag variable S.3 into the contact in room 2. Right-click on room 0 and insert a room below it. Drag into it a contact and a counter down with variables S.2 and C.1 respectively. And a one-shot rising in between them. Set the counter down preset to 1. Then go to the simulation mode. Repeatedly right-click on S.1 button to increase ACC value. Observe that the ACC value of counter up and counter down increases and are the same. When ACC is equal to the preset value of counter up, DN becomes true. Repeatedly right-click on S.2 button and observe that both ACC value decreases, while DN remains true. When ACC goes below the preset value of the counter down, DN will become false. S.3 can be used to reset the counters at any time. When the code is uploaded into the PLC and the switch connected to S.1 is pressed 5 times, the indicator lamp should come on. Then press S.2 switch 5 times. The indicator lamp should go off. In the next video, we will incorporate a timer and a counter to the water level control program from video number 5. If you found this video helpful, hit the like button and drop a comment in the comment section. Click on the subscribe button and the notification bell if you have not. See you in the next video.